it's been very different, unusual, I must say, and it's the same for everybody. You know, initially, when we heard about the coronavirus, we thought maybe 2-3 months, but now we know that life has changed. Last tournament we participated was in the National Sixth Test Championship in Ahmedabad, which ended sometime during the second week of March. In fact, I remember returning to Bangalore on March 11th, 12th. And after that, I haven't played a tournament since, and nobody has. But now I think we've just got to live with what we have. And, you know, this year, most likely, I mean, for us, at least for sure, for billiards and snooker, there are no tournaments until the end of the year. But it's also important to keep yourself stimulated, to be in touch with the game, because whenever the tournament happens next, at least you're in good touch. And this is a time to now work on different aspects of my game, even if it's fitness, because our sport is not necessarily associated with, you know, muscle and strength training and all. But we can always add different dimensions to our preparation. Honestly, I do believe that things could get better, but I also feel that here's where the federations also need to step up. You know, if cricket is popular, it's because of the efforts of BCCI over the last 2-3 decades. So every federation needs to step up and say, listen, we have a product. It's not like snooker and billiards is not known. A lot of youngsters love to play the sport. It's just about how to attract them, what kind of product we want to package and put out there and position it in a way where it attracts many eyeballs. You never know. But if you don't make the effort, if the effort is lacking or if the visibility isn't that much, then obviously even whoever achieves, whether it's me today, it could be somebody else tomorrow, will not get that kind of visibility and attention or appreciation, as you said, for their achievements. So, you know, it's a combination of various factors. And I feel that one is obviously television. Secondly, we obviously need to appreciate non-Olympic sports as well. It's not just about Olympic sports and cricket. We're very, very focused on the Olympics, which is a good thing. You know, I do believe that Olympics is a massive event. But I also feel that it's not the be-all of Indian sport. It's not the be-all of sport in general. I mean, Federer was asked what would he prefer between winning an Olympic gold and a Wimbledon. And he said Wimbledon immediately. So everyone has, you know, a different set of goals and priorities. First of all, it's a great initiative to talk about the defining moments of Indian sport, and it's, you know, it's truly an honor to be part of that elite list. And Saurav, I know Saurav for a while. You know, he's a great squash player. He's done well for his country, and he continues to improve in his sport. But what I enjoyed about the interview is that he went into depth about certain matches that I played while achieving a grand double, you know, winning the IBSF World Billiards and Snooker Championship, which was the first time it ever happened in the history of the sport. So it's good to talk about the mindset, because a fellow athlete understands what you go through, you know, the gamut of emotions you experience while competing at the highest level. And it's not that you always get to play your best every day. So to be able to explain that to the viewers, whoever they are going to be, it's very, very interesting, because we always feel that, oh, an athlete, if he's in peak condition, if he's in the best form of his life, is going to play his best every single day. I also, you know what, I wanted to say that I think I did mention in that interview, I don't remember now clearly, but it's about how you manage your off days. So we spoke about that as well, you know, how to sort of tone it down, to be a little more defensive when you're not playing your attacking best. But when you're playing your best, when you're in full rhythm and flow, then you can go all out and score heavily. So we just talk about different strategies in sport, and I just feel like that, you know, I'm glad that they put me on that list of, you know, being the most defining moments of Indian sport.